Can MTHFR cause ADHD? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Okay, Cesar Davila, last question. Cesar Davila says, I have ADHD. I manage it as best I can with exercise and eating a high folate and Mediterranean diet. What is your take on the correlations between 30 to 60% MTHFR variant and symptoms like ADHD? An MTHFR variant reduces the metabolic process of absorbing less nutrition and poor gut detoxification. When I don't get enough sleep, it is often correlated to poor gut health and increased ADHD. I managed to dramatically improve sleep consistently by drinking bone broth every night. How does drinking bone broth improve sleep and improve methylation? And is there anything else you could recommend to improve gut health for sleep? I'm doubtful that MTHFR has a huge impact on detoxification. I think a lot of people are assuming that because methylation plays a role in detoxification. I doubt it. I doubt that's the main thing that's going on. Definitely makes sense that you could have poor gut health and increased ADHD tied together. The gut and psychology syndrome is based on the connection between gut dysfunction causing psychiatric problems. So it, you know, that's definitely relevant. And then, of course, the gut can produce things like histamine that can produce constant stimulation that prevents you from falling asleep, and that can also worsen the problem. So there's lots of ways that that could happen. And MTHFR could lower the removal of histamine. So that's one thing. I think MTHFR... You know, if you have low methylation, that should actually make you more mentally rigid, not more ADHD. Whereas over methylation of dopamine will make you more towards the ADHD side. But when you have low MTHFR and low methylfolate levels, that can cause glycine wasting. And glycine improves sleep. Bone broth contains glycine. So the glycine wasting that occurs with MTHFR would explain why you have improved gut health. It would explain why you have improved sleep with drinking bone broth every night. And I think it's possible that glycine as an inhibitory neurotransmitter might have some impact on ADHD. Although I think ADHD is largely driven by not enough dopamine, not enough tonic dopamine, and maybe not enough GABA signaling. Now, methylation is used in dopamine synthesis at some level, but the main effect of methylation is generally to reduce the level, the background amount So methylation will reduce the background level of tonic dopamine and make you more mentally flexible, and a lack of methylation will generally lead to a higher level of background dopamine and make you not as mentally flexible. So I really don't think that the ADHD is solely a consequence of MTHFR. I think the MTHFR is, you know, low methylation state and glycine wasting is probably playing into some of the aggravating factors, particularly glycine wasting. And the fact that you benefit so much from drinking bone broth to improve your sleep suggests that you do run low in glycine. Okay, Cesar, I hope that helps answer your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.